Oh, ships and bright stars.
Good morning, graduates. I'm honored to be here with you today as you mark a milestone in your life journey. You have worked hard, overcome many challenges, and persevered through difficult times to reach this moment. As you celebrate your achievements and look forward to the future, I want you to remember three things. Firstly, remember the power of education. Your time at Cumberland Valley High School has given you the tools and knowledge to make a positive impact on the world. Education is the foundation of progress and the key to unlocking your full potential. As the great Nelson Mandela once said, education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. So use your education to make a difference in the world around you, to inspire others, and continue learning throughout your life. Secondly, remember the importance of human connections. The relationships you have built with your classmates, teachers, family, and friends are invaluable. They have supported you, encouraged you, and challenged you to be your best self. Take time to appreciate these connections and cherish them as you move forward with life. As the famous poet Maya Angelou once said, "I've learned that people will forget what you said, people will forget what you did, but people will never forget how you made them feel." So be kind, compassionate, and understanding to those around you, and you will make a lasting impact. Lastly, I encourage you to pursue your passions with courage and determination. As you go forward in life, you will encounter obstacles and setbacks, but do not let them deter you. As the late Steve Jobs once said, your work is going to fill a large part of your life. And the only way to be truly satisfied is to do what you believe is great work. And the only way to do great work is to love what you do. So follow your dreams, pursue your interests, and be bold in your endeavors. You have the potential to make a difference in this world, and it all starts in believing in yourselves and your abilities. So in conclusion, I want to congratulate you once again from your graduation at Cumberland Valley High School. You have accomplished so much, and I am confident that you will go on to do great things in your life. Remember the power of education, the importance of human connections, and the value of pursuing your passions with courage and determination. May you find happiness, success, and fulfillment in your future endeavors. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Good morning, everyone. Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
I'm so honored to have served as your class president these past 4 years. I'd like to give a special shout out to my class advisors, Mrs. Blacksmith and Mrs. Hayes, and my other class officers, Mayor, Richie, Audrey, and especially Lily Graff for helping me write this speech. My name is Cindy Krebs, but some of you may know me as 23skrebs@cbstudents.org. For those confused in the audience, these are the emails given to us in elementary school. 23, first initial, last name. It became our identity at CB. We used those usernames for countless projects, emails, and PowerPoints. From writing our fifth grade letters to our future selves, to polishing off our POLs, it has all been under the same Google account. 23, first initial, last name. When we were young, we all questioned what the number in the beginning was, the infamous 23. All the boys thought it was a shout out to Michael Jordan, but eventually we were told that 2023 was the year that we would graduate. 23 was the number that was put right in front of our face every day, every project, yet it always felt so far away. All we ever wanted was to grow up, to reach that glorious 23. We started off playing our DSs on the bus, waiting for our parents to get us from the bus stop. I remember riding the bus with Vikram, our valedictorian. Let's give it up for him! He used to make me quiz him with flashcards on the bus ride home, when I was still learning to tie my shoes. We called him the human dictionary, and look at him now, going to Princeton. Maybe I should ask him to quiz me in return. These emails, all being the same, tied us together. We formed friendships to last lifetimes and learned from teachers who inspired us to follow our dreams. All of us 23s, we were together through it all. We lived through so many things like COVID, Be Real, Gangnam Style, Musical.ly, the Kardashians, to the tragic day the Queen fell. But I was okay, I got right back up. We grew up too fast, wanting to be tall enough to ride roller coasters and drive around with our friends. Now that we are here, it's hard to process that we finally reached 23. That those little kids are now young adults who must move on to real world things. And as much as it saddens us to say goodbye, in the words of a modern day philosopher, Lizzo, it's about dang time. They're deleting our Google accounts now, which means that we will lose that 23 identity which we've been sheltered under these past 13 years. However, this is a time where we come up with our own usernames, our own identities outside of familiar territory. Seize each opportunity, take risks, and step outside your comfort zone. And if you ever find yourself missing your classmates, just go to crunch on the Carlisle Pike. I'll be trying to squat and I see my entire math class strolling in. Let's be honest, I don't go to crunch. I prefer to crunch on snacks. So whether you become president, a doctor, a teacher, or wherever your path takes you, always remember who you started as. 23, first initial, last name. Thank you.
Our next speaker will be the class of 2023 salutatorian, Sean O'Leary. COSA, Neuroscience Club, the Red Cross Club, the Spanish Club, National Honor Society, and the National World Language Honor Society. While at Cumberland Valley High School, Sean is an AP Scholar with Honor and earned the National Merit Scholarship Letter of Commendation. Please welcome Sean O'Leary.
Hello everyone, and thank you all for being here. Parents and students, family and friends, teachers, administrators, the guy in the back who thought this was a hockey game. I welcome you all. And I know you've heard this enough by now, but graduation is quite the accomplishment. And I'm so glad to see everyone here today to recognize the achievements of all of us graduating students here. Now, to be perfectly honest with you, when I was first asked to give this speech, I was actually quite nervous at the idea. I have social anxiety, so having to speak in front of a large crowd of thousands of people is never something that's ever been at the top of my bucket list. But At the same time, being able to give this speech is also an incredible honor, and I just hope that what I have to say may turn out to be some good words of advice or encouragement for you all today. Now, being here is a great honor, not just for me, but for all of the students here today, who have worked so hard to be where they are now. But, as I'm sure many of you have heard before, graduation is only the beginning of your journey. Now, as cliche as that statement is, I think that there is a lot of truth to that statement, more than people realize. I think a lot of us feel the pressure of this daunting expectation that after we graduate, we have to have our entire lives figured out. Even though, personally speaking, I'm still 17. Not even the government thinks I'm old enough to make my own decisions. And I'm pretty sure life doesn't get automatically sorted out either the moment you turn 18, or at least I've been told. So, in all seriousness, I think it's natural for people to change their minds throughout their journey, whether it be at college or in the workforce. The real world is a lot bigger than Cumberland Valley, and we're all going to find that to be the case soon. In the years to come, we're all going to be a lot more exposed to this crazy thing called life. And I think it's important for us to keep all this in mind, that through the uncertainty in our journeys, that the experiences and the challenges we come across will shape us into our own unique people and can even help develop passions of our own. Now, something I've noticed the past couple of years in high school is that we kind of like to compare ourselves to others. Now, I know this isn't the most revolutionary observation I've ever made, but at the same time, I think it's definitely true, and it's something I also am guilty of. But I think we all get wrapped up in this need-to-know mindset about what everyone else is doing, when we're all our own people with our own unique goals. We all have unique life experiences that have led us to our passions and aspirations. And most importantly, we all have our own struggles. Now, I'm sure everyone standing before you today has had at least one challenge they've had to deal with, or at the very least, I sure hope so after graduating. Now, our struggles shape us, and in a way, they define us. They can help make us better, stronger people, but in the moment, they may certainly not feel like that. Here's an example, yours truly. If there are any struggles that have shaped me as a person, it would probably be my long list of medical issues. Among other problems I've had, I have what's called Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, or EDS, which, long story short, my body essentially doesn't make collagen properly, and along with other issues, it means that my joints end up being very weak. EDS, or at least the kind I have, is an invisible disability. And so to my peers, or even some of my doctors, it may seem as if there's nothing actually wrong, or at the very least, no overarching medical condition. It took me a while to figure out what was actually wrong with me, and needless to say, I had a lot of frustrations because I was experiencing all these very real symptoms from a young age, yet doctors just didn't have an answer to what was going on with me. Luckily, at the age of 13, eventually, I did meet a group of doctors who were able to be qualified knowing what EDS was, because it's something that's not taught a lot, and I think it's a shame. But eventually, I did get diagnosed for it, and it's given me a great deal of validation in facing my challenges. Now, I share this before you, not just to rant about my personal life, but because it's something that has helped me to find passions of my own. Both the frustration and relief I encountered in my journey as a patient have led me to find my own passion in medicine as a doctor. I want to be able to give others the same validation and relief I felt when doctors were finally able to give me the validation and the answers that I had been searching for. Despite unfortunate circumstances, these experiences gave me passion and purpose for something. And what I've found is that our circumstances can be used in positive ways to help us find new aspects of ourselves. Now, I know for a fact that a lot of people here, although probably more than excited to get out of here, are also a little bit apprehensive about what the future brings. And many of us are still probably trying to find the things that we have passion in and the things that we actually want to do in our lives. And many of us are still trying to struggle that out. And for people like me, who think they have at least somewhat figured out, I'm still very well aware that my passions can still change. If I could emphasize one thing, it's try and find something you're truly passionate in, and embrace it to the fullest. And if your passion doesn't happen to align with your job, that's okay too. People need money, I'm aware. And at the very least, I'm sure you're passionate about being able to afford food. So, if your job doesn't happen to align with your passion, that's okay too. Just try to embrace passion in your life, however that may look for you. Embrace what makes you happy, and stop comparing yourselves to others. Just do what speaks to you in your own unique life experiences. Now, to wrap this up, I'd like to thank the many people in my life. But this is a 7-minute speech, so I'm going to keep it brief. Now, I'd of course love to thank my parents for always being there for me and for allowing me to pursue my interests, as you heard. Honorable mention to my siblings too, I guess. You guys are cool too. I'd also love to thank my favorite app, Schoology, for always being there. We've been through some tough times together. So, goodbye, and good riddance. I'd also love to thank a lot of teachers, but I'd especially love to thank my middle school teacher, Mr. Ellicker, who's here today, for being the nicest, funniest teacher ever, and for making me really enjoy math, an amazing feat. Funniest teacher ever, I loved him. I loved math, or at least until I got to ninth grade and had pre-calc and changed my mind. But for the time being, it was great. I hope you enjoy your retirement as a teacher and know how much of a difference you had on students, since my entire algebra class still stays in contact to you till this day. And finally, I'd love to thank my classmates for an incredible year, and here's to a bright future, wherever your passions lie. Thank you.
Bigham was the TSA Vice President and founder of Harrisburg Area Math Circle. He was also a member of the National Honor Society, FBLA, Key Club, Knowledge Masters, and the Science Olympiad team. While at Cumberland High School, Bigham was an AP Scholar with Distinction, a National Merit Scholar, and he plans on attending Princeton University to major in chemistry. Please welcome Bigham Kakaria.
Class of 2023, the faculty, the staff, the administrators, and our families, without whom none of this would have been possible. First of all, I just want to say sorry to anyone I promised a shout out because I probably forgot. First, I'd like to thank my fellow classmates, so let's have a round of applause for all of us for the class of 2023. Guiding me along the way and spending away a lot of my college fund on a variety of annoying alarm clocks. Without their persistence, I would probably hold the record for the most tardies in CV history. I'd also like to thank my brother Rohan, who managed to keep me from getting speeding tickets with his Hawkeye for cop cars on our morning drives to school. In all seriousness though, without the support of my family, my friends, my grandparents who took time to be here today, I would not be able to be here and I definitely wouldn't be speaking in front of you all. When I was called down to Dr. Rawl's office and was asked to give this speech, I was suffering from a terrible, horrible disease. Some symptoms include laziness, lack of motivation, unexcused absences, and excessive sleepiness. I think you know what I'm all talking about. Senioritis. An affliction that we have all suffered from. Determined to cure myself, I planned to write this speech ahead of time, something I don't recall doing at all in high school. And it didn't happen this time either. Anyways, while drafting the speech, I thought back to the summers, when the CV calendar arrived in my mailbox every year. I always noticed that usually in the middle of June, there was a Saturday labeled commencement. I never truly understood why graduation was named commencement, since the word commencement signifies the beginning of something new. I thought of graduation as the end of high school, where students like ourselves today would walk onto the stage and claim their reward for 13 years of diligence and perseverance. And I bet a lot of you are thinking right now, bro, can this guy just shut up so he can graduate? Well, I thank you for your patience, and don't worry, I won't be long. But I think it is important for us to understand who we are, where we came from, and where we're going. And as I look out at this enormous body of graduates, I've come to realize that the term commencement is fitting. We, the class of 2023, are beginning a new chapter of our lives, a journey into the future. That is where we are going. We will use our experiences forged together in high school to guide us along our paths. And what a journey it has been. So thinking back to freshman year, the thought of entering a school the size of Cumberland Valley seemed intimidating to say the least. Being in a class of over 700 students furthered this fear of feeling lost in a vast sea of numbers. But even in the sea, a boat can find its way to shore. Freshman year brought many new beginnings and many new faces as I asked for directions daily in the cafeteria for at least the first month of school. A lot of my friends know that I don't have the best sense of direction. And we certainly had a warm welcome with the annual booing of the freshmen at the homecoming pep rally. We got revenge this year. Unfortunately, however, freshman year came to a sudden halt when we were told that we would go home for 2 weeks. Remember that? Which ended up turning into 2 years. However, as the doors of Cumberland Valley High School shut on us, new doors began to open. For me, those doors brought a lot more sleep, submitting assignments at 11:58, and watching a lot of NFL. Despite much more procrastination, these trying times helped us navigate uncharted waters and dreaded Wednesdays, the days with no class and only never-ending asynchronous assignments. In the end, though, we overcame these challenges and we grew as individuals. And then came junior year. We were back in school, fully masked up. At least some of us. For instance, a lot of us thought it was extremely important to protect our chins from the coronavirus by wearing our masks under our noses. However, we did the best we could. We came into junior year excited to interact with each other in person with a newfound appreciation for each other and for our school experience. Of course, junior year lived up to its infamy in the tedious work, the constant assignments, and a personal hatred of the College Board. And then came this year, our year. As seniors, we finally ruled the school. We were the ones booing the freshmen, winning the pep rallies, and sleeping through classes. And for those of us going to college, after our college applications were done, the new pandemic, senioritis, began as another one ended. Thanks to all the teachers for putting up with us over the past few months. I know we haven't made it easy. But this year was full of many memorable moments, including our first normal mini-thon event in 3 years, football games, and many unexplained Fridays off. And many of us excelled in athletics, music, art, academic competitions, and other unique activities that enriched our lives and made our 4 years of high school more bearable. As we come to the end of our time together as Cumberland Valley Eagles here today, we embark on our next voyage. As we venture away from the shore, life will take us in many different directions. And at times, we may regret some of our decisions or wish they had gone another way. But if we try to look at what could have been, we will constantly be unhappy and then realize how much we would have sacrificed by choosing a different path. In the end, it is important for us to not focus on the what ifs, but rather on the what is. So what is the next step for us, fellow graduates? Well, in the words of Mark Twain, sail away from the safe harbor, catch the trade winds in your sails, explore, dream, discover. We have a world of opportunities that lies ahead of us. We can do anything. So here's to the class of 2023 and to our new beginning.
Thank you. the support of their parents and loved ones. And it's not easy raising children. They may think it's easy, but we know something different. It's hard work. It's hard work, but you got them here, some kicking and screaming, some running fast, but they're here today. So I'm going to ask our young people to stand up and give their parents and loved ones a standing ovation and a round of applause. You can stand at this time. So by my count, I've reached a milestone today. Today is my 18th graduation ceremony as a high school principal. I'm prior to many of the young people sitting in front of me being in school. But the importance of this ceremony is never lost on me. It is a really, really big deal. Today, our young people are getting ready to take another path to their life. They're going on to another journey. So today is a monumental day in their lives, but it was a day that was not guaranteed. And you may say, well, 4 years ago, I entered high school. And I just assumed and just thought I was going to graduate and walk the stage. True, but that's not what I'm talking about. See, I don't think you're giving your time here enough credit. You may not understand the true time and the true score of this moment. Like I always tell people, don't miss a moment. You know, sometimes someone may say something to you that could change your life. So you always have to take mental notes and put some paper in your pocket. So grab on to something that I'm going to say to you these next few moments and see if they make a difference. Because every time I see young people get ready to graduate, I get emotional because I know what the journey is like once you leave these doors of the Job Center. But the actual chances of you being here today, I mean living and breathing, in the Job Center, at this moment, is so slim that most people say it's zero. One person said it's like 2 million people sitting down at the exact same time in the exact same city. And then those 2 million people have dice in their hand. Not the six faces, but a trillion faces on those dice. And they roll those dice at the exact same time. Those 2 million people sit down in the same city at the exact same time and roll the dice. And they all come up with the same number. That's the chances of you being here right now. So my friends, I will say to you that that just can't happen. But here's the thing, it did. And you're here right now in the Giant Center getting ready to graduate from high school. You know, Les Brown, a great speaker, he said this. And here's something to think about. He said that the place with the most unwritten books, the most unspoken speeches, is not in the library, on social media, but it's actually in the graveyard. Because the graveyard is where dreams go to die, where unfulfilled potential goes to die. But you're here today, and I want you to understand this, that all of us have a unique problem that only we can solve. Only you can solve a certain problem. That's why you're here. That there's a situation or a thought or an idea or a speech that you have to give that only you can give. No one else can give the speech. No one else can write the book. No one else can complete the computer program. No one can do that but you. You have a unique problem that you have to solve. And so always understand that as you walk through life, that there's something for you that only you can do. Early in the year, we had a chance to meet a gentleman by the name of Keith Bocan. He came to our school and spoke to us. He had written and produced the movie Till. And we had a chance to speak to him, but what moved me the most about him, like what moved me the most about him, is he said, look, I just didn't start this project. You know, I just started writing this 2 years ago. He said, I spent my whole life doing this. He said, I spent my whole life trying to bring not the death of Emmett Till's people's attention, but the life of his mother and what she did afterwards. And he spent his whole life doing that. And he was a man that did not miss his moment. He was a man that understood what he was supposed to do, and he went to accomplish it. And you have to believe there were a lot of ups and downs, ins and outs, a lot of no's, sometimes yeses, but he kept going on because he knew he had a unique problem that he had to solve. And you are no different. And you see, the other day, this is where the song and the thought came to me. The other day, I was driving down the highway, and I told the teachers this. I was driving down the highway headed home, and a bald eagle came across my windshield. Like, first time I've ever seen a bald eagle in my life, but he crossed the highway. And I thought two things. Thought a lot of things. First, I said, well, that must mean I'm supposed to be a Cumberland Valley eagle. But I saw the eagle pass by me, and I could actually see it this time. There was another time that I was out with a friend. We were in the parking lot, and he was like, Jesse, there's a bald eagle in the sky. I said, I can't see it. He said, it's up there. I said, I see something, but I don't know if that's a bald eagle or not. It was really far up there. So I found out, after I saw that eagle, I found out that a bald eagle can ascend to like 10,000 feet in the air. Right? A bald eagle can ascend to 10,000 feet in the air. I found out that a bald eagle can go through the storm. And if there is a storm, sometimes it can go over the storm. But every day that bald eagle, right, when it goes out to take flight, it catches an air current that was meant just for it. Because that's how bald eagles fly. They fly off of air currents, but there's an air current for that bald eagle that was only meant for that bald eagle on that day for it to ascend to 10,000 feet. And it took advantage of that air current because it got out of the nest, did what it needed to do so it could keep living and help others live, other bald eagles live. You see, every day that bald eagle takes flight because it must do what it has to do to survive. And then I think, are we no different? Are we no different? Every day, right, we're going to have to understand the problem that we're trying to solve in life and the many ups and downs that come this way. But when we leave the house, when we leave in the morning, we get up, we have to understand that we need to catch that air current. And we too must rise up to chase the dream and solve the problem that we must solve and we must deliver on. So I say to you that when you leave here, when you leave this building and you go on to your next station in life, understand it's not going to be easy. There's going to be doubters and haters and people telling you what you can't do. But I say to you, rise up. When you leave this place, you'll have ups and downs. You'll have a dream that you want to fulfill, but it'll feel like you just can't do it. But on those days, get out of the bed, catch that air current, and rise up and do what you need to do to take your next station in life. Life is not easy. Life is not easy. The worst lie you were ever told was happily ever after. That is not a thing. That's not a thing. You will be challenged in life beyond your wildest dreams. Your hands from right to left.